Hey guys, what's up and welcome to my tutorial video. Guys, thank you so much for clicking on this video. And guys, in today's video we are going to discuss a very confusing but a very important topic about Adobe Photoshop, and that's going to be about resolution. I'm going to discuss all sorts of things, okay, when it comes to resolution, like how do you upsample or downsample an image, why should you upsample or downsample an image, and you know, how do you do it, and like, you know, all sorts of things, guys. Okay, so let's get started. For today's video, guys, I have got these two images ready, right? One is the original version, and you can see, guys, it is quite a good image, guys, taken of this Golden Gate Bridge. And you can see, guys, when I zoom into it, you can see I still have all my details, and I, you know, there is no pixelation happening when I'm zooming into it, okay? So it's a good image, it's a good HD image, right? Taken by a higher-end camera. And guys, when I go to the same image, okay, a smaller version of this image, or the downsampled version of this image, you can see, guys, that it doesn't take up the full screen because it is a smaller version of the image. What I have done is, guys, that I have reduced the resolution of this original image from 300 ppi or pixels per inch, right, 300 pixels per inch, all the way to 72 ppi or pixels per inch. So you can see that there is a big difference happening when you change the resolution of image, okay, taking it from high resolution to a low resolution. But guys, you know, when you change the resolution, there are lots of other things also happening, okay? So it's not only about the size of the image or the height and the length of the image, you know, all sorts of other things are also happening. So let's take a look at them, alright, in Adobe Photoshop. I'm gonna press Ctrl O quickly and import these two images and click open. And awesome. Wait a sec. What? Only one of them got imported. Wait a sec. Yeah, awesome. I'm gonna click. And yeah, guys, now guys, what I've done is I've pressed Ctrl 0 for fit and view option, and you can see, guys, that when I've done that, my original image, my OG image, guys, it is still very nice and crystal clear, okay? I can still take a look at all my details and all, but when I take a, you know, when I have done this fit and option command in Adobe Photoshop on this image, you can see that there is blurriness happening. Now why is that? Now like I said, guys, I've reduced the resolution of this image. So firstly, guys, I've prepared some questions. So let's take a look at the first question. How to downsample an image, or how do you downsample or upsample an image, okay? Now this question also brings my second question up. Oh, why to downsample an image? Why to downsample or upsample an image? So firstly, guys, in the graphics world, okay, when you will be working with any company, and this is a basic rule in graphics, okay, when you are working with softwares like Illustrator and Photoshop, that guys, whenever you are creating something for printing purposes, okay, like your client has come to you and said that, you know, I want a banner and I want to make, like, say, 1,000, 2,000 printouts of it, I want to send it, you know, in my newspapers and all. So you will always, people will work with 300 pixels per inch or a 300 ppi or 300 resolution. You will always keep a resolution to a very high extent, and 300 ppi is a minimum that you should keep, okay? If the client comes and says that you that he wants it on 600, if he wants to make some billboards out of it, and like, you know, some really big thing like posters and all, then you will be needing, but you know, that's like another thing, you may be needing to increase the resolution that time, but the minimum, guys, is 300 pixels per inch. But guys, when it comes to display purposes, okay, like say if you are putting an image on internet, okay, if you are editing an image and you're putting it on internet, then guys, you will you know, you may want to reduce the resolution to 72 pixels per inch. This is a basic rule, okay, that you should understand, that for display purposes it is 72 and for printing purposes it is 300. Now why do we follow this rule? Firstly, guys, if you take a 300 pixels per inch and put it in your website, okay, because Photoshop, guys, is used for that. Sometimes, guys, we use Photoshop for creating a whole web page, okay, design a whole web page in Adobe Photoshop, and then, guys, we take it to Dreamweaver and all other sorts of softwares which are related to HTML and all that kind of stuff, okay, that comes in web designing, like, you know, coding and all, but the designing is happening in Photoshop. So guys, if I use a 300 pixels per inch image or 300 resolution image into my website, some people, guys, who are using like a slow speed internet, they may have some problems, guys, and you know, they may really get irritated and all. So we don't want to lose our customers on that part. You know, say if you are trying to create like you know a website which shows all fashion bags and you know like fashion accessories. You know, you would like to you know, you would not want your customers to wait for the image to load up. So you know, you always use a low resolution image. So that's like our rule, right? So just remember that part. The next thing, guys, that you that is a reason that why should you downsample or upsample an image is because of this part. I'm gonna press, and this time, guys, I'm gonna show you how do you downsample an image. Okay, it's basically very easy, guys. Just hold on Control Alt I for, and actually it's a keyboard shortcut, right? And this is the part, guys. This is a place where you can change the resolution. Right now, guys, this is the OG image, my original version of the image, and you can see that the resolution is 300. If I want, guys, I can change it to 72 and take a look at what's and you can just press OK for applying the changes, and the changes will be applied. Okay, now let's take a look at what's happening to the size. When this image was 300 pixel resolution, guys, okay, the size was 7 megabytes. Okay, and guys, when I have changed it to 72, take a look what's happened to the size. It has gone down to 400 KB only. So guys, you know, when you are working with a banner or say a post or something, guys, you would, you know, you would want to create like some duplicate, or you know, you would like to create 2-3 versions in which you have applied, you know, different effects, and you would like to represent it to your client. And yeah, guys, one good use of this downsample is, let's say, guys, that if you have prepared something, okay, you can quickly downsample that image and email it to your client or customer. Because guys, you know, it can be tough sometimes, because I think that Yahoo and Gmail and all those kind of things, you know, have that that kind of a limit that they will not accept any file that is above 25 MB. So you know, that time, guys, that this downsample trick can really help you out when you want to send your images, okay, to a customer. Just downsample that image quickly. And if you press OK, guys, you can see that, you know, that the image has, like, the changes have been applied. I'm gonna press Control Z, Control Alt I again to discuss something. And yeah, guys, you can just quickly change it to 72, and you'll see, guys, that the size really drops down, guys. Okay, and you can click OK for applying changes. So I hope you guys are understanding what I'm trying to say. Yeah, guys, now I would like to explain how this thing works. Okay, this is good when you're trying to downsample an image. What if, guys, what will happen, guys, if you're trying to upsample an image? And yeah, guys, upsample just basically means taking a low resolution file and, you know, increasing the resolution and making it a very clear image. Okay, but that's not the case. That doesn't happen, people. Sometimes, guys, like, say if I roll Alt I, and just for explanation purposes, guys, I'm gonna reduce the resolution all the way down to 10. This is like a very low res, guys. Okay, I'm gonna zoom into this. You can see, guys, that how blurry it is. Actually, I cannot see anything. I cannot even understand that this thing is a bridge. But say, guys, that now I want to you know, upsample this image. Now how will I do this? Control Alt I. Okay, now this is a basic thing, okay, and you'll just increase the resolution, right? I click OK. But take a look at this thing. So what I'm trying to say is, guys, what you have done is that, you know, you have introduced fake pixels in this image. You have told Adobe Photoshop that Photoshop take say it was this image before was 10 resolution. You have introduced 90 more resolution, okay, 90 more blocks of the image, okay, all these small blocks, you know, which we have. You have introduced 90 more blocks, okay, and they were actually totally white. And so therefore, guys, what Photoshop has done is it has copied the nearest box to it. So guys, you can see that when you are trying to upsample an image, okay, you will always have this blurriness. So guys, we always prefer to downsample an image but never upsample an image. So therefore, guys, always keep this original version. Okay, I'm gonna close down this thing because I don't need it anymore. Always try to keep your this original file saved. And on, guys, when you are working with an image, always try to demand or always try to ask for the original picture that came out of a good high-end camera. Okay, like say this was a good high-end camera used for the for taking this shot. So and luckily I have this thing for showing it to you. So you know, always try to ask for that image. You know, that's gonna keep you, like, you know, in advantage. And yeah, so I hope you guys understood. And yeah, I think I've discussed this part, which rest to use, as in which rest to use where. So 72 resolution to be used for display purposes, for web purposes, guys. and 300 pixels per inch or resolution to be used for printing purposes. Okay, all right, awesome. How to save your images. All right, I think I'm gonna discuss this part a little more before it gets 15 minutes. And yeah, okay, so how to save your images. This is a very good question. I would say, guys, that firstly, I've told you that always you have to ask for a good higher-end image, like, you know, the original image that came out of a good camera, you know, and then you can, you know, so you can work with it nicely. And then, guys, I would always recommend you guys to get into this habit of saving your documents as PSD files. Like, for example, guys, you can, you know, like most of you guys would like to render out your unfinished business. Don't try to do that, guys. Always save it as a PSD. And yeah, guys, this is like very basic. And yeah, guys, come up, like, you know, try to get organized, guys. All right. Try to create folders, proper folders, and, you know, then save it as a PSD. Get into this habit of saving files, guys. Saving files frequently into the PSD format, so you have all your layers to edit with, and all the layer styles also. So, you know, you can come to your image anytime you want, and, you know, you can play with that, and, you know, you'll be good, guys. Okay, and then, guys, when you are like very sure that, yeah, that now I want to finish it, don't, you know, that time also, guys, do not delete the PSD file. Okay, always try to keep and store your PSD file. And the best part about Photoshop is, guys, that even when like you are using an image into Photoshop, and then, guys, you delete that image from your hard disk, Photoshop will always keep that into the PSD. So that's like an awesome thing. Do not delete the PSD, guys. Okay, the PSD files, because that can be really important. Okay, and yeah, I think that's pretty much it, guys. So yeah, I think I've discussed everything that there was to discuss in the video. Yeah, how to downsample, how to upsample the image, why should you do it, and yeah, I think I have discussed everything. So thank you for watching this video, guys. All right, if you guys liked it, if this was of any help, please subscribe to me. Okay, please subscribe, and you'll be awesome. And thank you for watching this video. Thank you. Peace.